Yo, what is going on, guys? It's your boy, Us We Trust here, bringing you guys episode 2 of my Road to Kage Status series. Don't really have a topic for today, or anything like in particular to talk about. I know my last episode, I just commentated over the matches, talked about what was going on and whatnot. So I don't really want to do that again. I don't know. I feel like it's just like a lot of work, and then plus it's like, I don't know. I just don't really feel like doing that. So I mean, obviously if there's something interesting going on, like in the match or something, yeah, I'll mention it. But I don't know. I kind of just wanted to enjoy the gameplay along with you guys. I have a ridiculous amount of matches recorded now. I think on ranked, I just hit 125 wins. And my current record, guys, if you guys are wondering, is about 125-49. I believe that's my exact record as of right now, or something very, very close to that. I'm not a huge, like, win-to-loss person, honestly. Well, let me take that back. In most games, like other stuff that I play, I am, I guess. But in Naruto, I don't know, man. I have disconnected 3 times in this game. I mean, shut off my Xbox, and I highly, highly discourage it. I would never tell, like, people, you know, that you should dashboard when you lose or anything like that. I've been dashboarded on a couple of times, actually, and yeah, definitely, it's not the best thing. And the only, every single time that I've disconnected, it's been against a Deidara with a 1 or a 2 bar, like a connection that was just basically unplayable. So yeah, that brings me to another topic, okay? And guys, I need to make something very, very clear. I am not racist, although this, I guess this wouldn't really, I don't think this is a racial issue. I don't know, okay, whatever. I'm basically just trying to say I'm not trying to, like, discriminate against, there we go, that's the word I was looking for. I'm not trying to discriminate against particular people or people from a certain region or anything. But why the fuck is it that whenever I get spammed, it is always, always from people from Australia? Why? Why? I don't understand. Mexico as well. I'm not gonna, it's the Mexico and Australia people that I just get spammed like there is no tomorrow. Every single time, I guarantee it. Mexico a little less than people from Australia. Like, if I fight somebody from Australia, it's literally like guaranteed 95% chance that I'm gonna get spammed by a Deidara. Like, I don't know what it is, but every single time, like, are Australians just like, are they just extremely fond of Deidara, or like, is Deidara supposed to be Australian? Like, I'm exaggerating on that guy. I know he's not Australian, but I'm just saying, like, I don't know what the deal is literally every single time. By the way, this match that you guys are watching, this Obito versus Itachi, is like crazy intense. You guys should check that out. Okay, now I lost my train of thought. Okay, so Deidara, yeah, like, I don't know what it is, guys. I don't know if you guys are experiencing the same things as me, which I don't know. I play a lot of ranked, I play a lot of tournament matches, but literally every single time I connect to somebody from Australia, I just get spammed. I don't know what it is. I just wanted to go ahead and throw that out there, like, and I kind of want to know if you guys are kind of experiencing, like, the same thing as me. Oh, excuse me. If you guys are experiencing the same thing as me, because it's just ridiculous, man. And I also get spammed by people, like I said, from people from Mexico all the time, like, literally, like, but see, they don't ever choose Deidara, or at least from my experience anyways. I get spammed by them with Massman. Just earlier today, I recorded a match. I didn't upload the match on this episode, but I will probably, I just wanted to save it for later on. But yeah, I got spammed by a masked man. He definitely did get nerfed, for sure, from generations. Like, that's just a fact. But you can still definitely, if you have a full bar of chakra, and let's say you have no subs, or you have one sub left, and you know your enemy has four, which was the case with me. I was Obito. I still had four subs left. Choji still makes me laugh so much, by the way. I had four subs, he had like one, and literally he had a full bar of chakra. All he did was jutsu over and over and over again, and he's still Bassman. I know they nerfed the damage on it and everything like that, like, but I still don't know why they didn't change the fact that he's invulnerable when he starts the jutsu. It's so stupid. Like, as long as you have chakra, you can sit there and just spam jutsu and just basically not even use it to to do damage. You're just using it to like wait out the clock, basically. It's just really, really dumb. I don't know. It's just really stupid. So anyways, like I said, when I play with people from Mexico, I tend to get spammed also, but I just mainly get spammed by like other people, like Massman, Kiba, just you name it, like just different characters, and they just basically spam jutsu. It's pretty fucking annoying. But yeah, so I don't know. I just want to know what, like, if you guys are experiencing any of the same things that I am, or what. Let's see. What else to talk about? Since we're on this match, you guys see me using Gaara, which is, you know, obviously, as I've told you guys before, is my main character, or my favorite character from the anime. As you guys know, like, I always, I've made videos about it before. I've always mained PTS Gaara, so the kid version of Gaara. I always, I really liked him. Like, he was just so, like, I don't know, he was, like, psychotic and, like cynical, like, the cynical kid. Like, it was, you know, if you guys have seen, if you guys watch the anime, you know, around the time where the, I think it's like the Chunin exams or whatever, when he's still younger. By the way, that was a sick combo that I'm, that I just got, Toby in right now. Yeah, he was just like, I just liked the character a lot. He was just like super, like, intimidating. He was just crazy, man. Like, people were like literally like scared of like dying to him. Nobody wanted to fight him. He was just a crazy beast. So anyways, that's why I always used him. And he did get nerfed extremely, extremely hard from Generations, which I am extremely, extremely happy about, by the way. I'm so happy that he got nerfed. People don't talk shit about him anymore. One of the things that made him extremely broken, or basically the thing that did make him broken, was the fact that you could use his jutsu and it would just follow the person. So, you know, even if you had like one sub and, you know, you were getting comboed and like the other person still had three, or basically had the sub advantage, you can call out jutsu and then like go start rushing them, and they'd have no choice but to block. And if they tried to like fight you back, then your jutsu would just smack them in the face. So they changed his jutsu, so basically it only goes in one direction. It'll like lock on and then just go there, so it's pretty easy to dodge. Just like a fireball or anything like that, you can just jump to the side, or what have you. So yeah, I'm super, super happy about that. Like, nobody uses him anymore. I remember beginning of Generations, nobody really used him, but towards the end of my experience on Generations, a lot of people started picking him up because they realized how overpowered he was. At the very least, they used him as a support. So, yeah, you don't ever see Gaara support anymore, ever, which was basically, like, in every single fight with, like, Hidan or Kimimaru, basically. That was, like, everybody's tryhard team. Not mine in particular, but the majority of people's. Real quick, guys, against this, you guys are watching this Obito match versus this Darui. Pay attention to how many times this fucking faggot grabs me. Like, literally, it is so fucking annoying. He's grabbed me at least four times, like, so far in the match. But I can just, like, I keep catching him without subs, and he just, see, look at him here, he's just grabbing, spamming grab. Like, it's fucking so gay. Like, Darui is a very good character. I think he's awesome, he's fast, obviously his fucking grab is very good. His jutsu is good, you know, all that stuff. You guys can ask Chris or CA, if you guys don't believe, I'm gonna bring some gameplay pretty soon here of me and him sparring, and Chris is using Darui. Like, there's no reason to fucking play him like this. Like, it's so fucking gay. Like, I don't know. Just, like I said, Chris has a really good Darui, but, like, playing like this, guys, is just fucking... It's just for fucking scrub-ass losers. Like, don't play characters like this. It's so dumb. Anyways, what the hell was I talking about? See, this is why I don't like going on tangents, because then I forget what the hell I was talking about. Shit. What was I talking about? Well, I completely forgot what I was talking about, so... That sucks. Hold on, give me a sec here. I don't know, guys. I'm pretty sure I lost it. I don't know what the hell I was talking about. Well, that blows. Anyways, well, yeah, so I end up beating this motherfucker because he's a faggot and just tries to spam grab over and over again. And it's ironic because I finish him off here with the grab, so yeah, taste of your own medicine, fucking turd. So yeah, he ends up getting taken out. Here, what is going on here? I am running with Zabuza, the second Hokage, and Haku versus a Fu. Okay, so Fu. I don't know what it is, but I was checking out the leaderboards. By the way, guys, I'm pretty happy. I just broke top 1,000 in this game in Ninja Storm 3 on the leaderboards. I believe I am 980 or something like that in the world. So yeah, I'm very happy about that. So yeah, like I was saying about Fu, I don't know, like, if she's supposed to be, like, extremely, extremely good. Don't get me, I know her fucking awakening is completely broken. It is completely broken. I have absolutely no problem with awakenings in this game. As a matter of fact, it's like, you know, I think CC2 did a good job of, making, like, awakenings, basically planning, like, your strategies, like, a lot better now. I think there's a lot more diversity in people's gameplay because of the fact that there's a lot of characters that can instant awaken, you know, stuff like that. But as far as, like, especially Fu's, like, monster form, like, the ones that this, because it's in the air, it's, like, and the hitboxes are so, so retarded on, like, bigger monsters like the Susanoo forms, Sasuke and Itachi, Fu's, like, stupid dragonfly or whatever the hell, like, they're just completely, like, broken. But yeah, so like I said, I have absolutely no problem with awakenings, but, like, hers is just, like, ridiculous, so I don't know if that's the case or what, but, me and Chris were looking over the leaderboards the other day, and we were, like, going down, like, checking out some people, by the way, this guy that I'm fighting right here, I'm using Obito against a PTS Gar, first one that I fought online, out of my 100 and, or 200 plus ranked matches. This is the first one that I'm fighting. He posted up with a really good record. He was like 300 and like 100 or something like that. It wasn't exact. It was like 360 to like 140 or something like that. But yeah, more or less, you guys get the idea. So he was definitely a good player. I started off like beating his ass, but he makes a pretty cool comeback here. So yeah, me and Chris were checking out the leaderboards, and so many people had Fu in their top three, like most used ninja. Like, you know, when you guys look at people's records, it'll show like their ranked records, their player matches, their tournaments won, and then like their most used ninja. And like, I want to say it was like 6 or 7 out of the 10 had Fu in their top 10. Like, it was ridiculous, man. I was like, what the hell? Like, why? I don't know. I didn't really know that. I don't know if they're like they're awakening with her or what the deal is. But then that very same day, it was ironic because I was hosting a tournament for Tournament Tuesdays, and you know, me, myself, CA, and Ink were all in the tournament. We were all just playing, and this Fu comes up, and literally, this girl made that Darui that you guys saw earlier in this episode look like he was It looked like he didn't try to grab me at all. She grabbed maybe, at the very, very least, she had grabbed every fight. She made it to the finals, by the way, and ended up winning the championship. Every single fight, she had to have grabbed at least 20 times. It was, I don't know, it was on some other shit, guys, honestly. Like, so I don't know if that's, like, people are using her because she has an amazing grab or because of her awakening or what, but, yeah, that was pretty intense. So, yeah, I don't know. And then I guess last thing, my overall experience so far with this game has been overall very good. I've just in general been fighting a lot less people who are like trying to spam to win, things like that. The community just seems like it's better than what Generation's community was. I know it's, there's a lot of the same people, but it, for some reason it just feels better to me. You guys let me know. I don't know if you guys feel the same way or not, but I don't know. That's how it feels to me. I see a lot more diversity in like characters. Well, actually, I don't know. There's a shitload of people who still like, you know, like Rock Nagato and Nagato, the Eternal whatever Sharingan of Sasuke version. You know, like the special version of him. There is a shitload of them. There's a shitload of Nagatos, and there's a shitload of Naruto, the tailed beast bomb ones. Other than that, though, I guess. Oh, and Hanzo, and the Hanzo, and okay. Last thing I'm gonna talk about. Mifune. What the fuck? I do not like that motherfucker. That old fucking retard. I do not like him. His jutsu is completely fucking stupid. Like, people literally, every single time you see a Mifune, who actually, like, who doesn't play, like, okay, basically, whenever you fight a Mifune, basically, every time you knock him down, the first thing they're gonna do, you might as well just start blocking, because the first thing they're gonna do is jutsu, because that shit is so fast, and it's just so stupid, man. Literally every single time I fight a Mifune, they just go like balls deep and like just awaken instantly and just chakra dash, chakra dash, chakra dash, jutsu, jutsu, jutsu. They play, you know, like extremely, extremely fast and just rush the shit out of you and don't give you a chance to breathe. Or they play completely back, play like complete turds, and just wait for you to chakra dash towards them and jutsu. And they jutsu. It's, I don't know, I'm not gonna go as far as to say like he's overpowered or anything like that, but he's one of those characters that, like, let's put it this way, if you could ban, if there were like a picks and ban sort of thing like League of Legends does in their rank system, I would ban Mifune every single time, because I do not like fighting that motherfucker. Pair him up with a Kimimaru and like a Itachi, like the Ito Itachi or Tsuchikage or some shit like that, and whew, good luck winning that fight. Anyways, guys, this has been my second episode of Road to Kage Status. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the fights. Let me know if you guys prefer the way that the first episode was done, you know, where I was commentating over the actual fights themselves, or if you guys kind of prefer this, where I'm just doing like the chill sort of talks. Whatever, I mean, I'll do whatever it is my subscribers want, so you guys just go ahead and let me know about how you guys feel about that. And so, yeah, that's about it. Anyways, guys, it is Friday, it is 8 o'clock a.m., well, it is here in California anyways, so I am going to take a shower, maybe get some breakfast, and then I got work at 1 o'clock today, so I will be there. I will be at GameStop from 1 to 9:30, and then I got the weekend off, so yep. Anyways, guys, hopefully you guys have a nice Friday. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the commentary, whenever it is you guys are watching this, and peace!